Hello and welcome to Sex Interpretations, presented by Courtney Fadlin. I am your host, Daroy Souden. Today we have a great lineup of artists who have come together not just to entertain us, but to usher us in the presence of God. Each of these artists will bring to you their own interpretation of music that touches the heart. It is our hope that each song will help you find healing during these times of protest and unrest, and will help to bring forth racial equality, lasting peace, love, and unity among us. At this time, Pastor Andre Campbell from Florida will lead us into prayer. Pastor Campbell?
Let us bow our heads. Father, we thank you for bringing us together tonight. With the use of technology, Lord, it doesn't matter where we are, what corner of the world, we can come together in fellowship and have a gathering where your name is called. Lord, today is your Sabbath day and we have rested. We have, and now we are coming to hear music that will bless our hearts, music that will calm our spirits, music that will lift our souls. And so tonight, Lord, as each musician is sharing, interpreting it with their own artistry, Lord, Father, we ask that your spirit will play with them and that our hearts will be touched. Lord, there's someone listening tonight who is sad and depressed. There's someone who's alone, who's lonely. Father, there's someone who has a decision to make. There's someone who's considering a transition in life, moving on to doing something different. Tonight, Lord, whatever their turmoil may be, whatever their trial, tribulation, or triumph may be, tonight, Lord, we ask that this sweet music will touch their hearts. We ask these things, knowing that you will do it, knowing that you are looking out for us in this world full of unrest, knowing that you have a plan that is abundantly a blessing to us. And so we ask these things in Jesus' name we pray, knowing you'll do it. Amen.
Amen. Yes, yes, yes. Welcome once again to Sax Interpretations. Our first artist was born in Guyana and migrated with his family to Suriname when he was only a year old. He was surrounded by music as his mom was a pianist and his dad a trumpeter. Although he enjoyed music of all genres, he specializes mostly in gospel. He has three albums to his credits, namely Miracle, Eclipse of Love, and his yet-to-be-released project, Winds of Praise. Some of his influences include Kirk Whalum, Kenny G, and others. He's performed for the President of Guyana, ambassadors, judges, parliamentarians, not just in Guyana, but also in Suriname and around the Caribbean. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you none other than Roy Stewart. Oh, yes. Beautiful music. Beautiful, beautiful music. Thank you so much, my brother, for that song. I have two questions for you. First question, at what age did you decide you wanted to do music?
Well, guys, to be honest, I never chose music. Music chose me.
That's a good thing. That's a good thing. And what has the experience been so far all these years?
So for all these years, it has been very remarkable. The journey has been amazing. And I am so grateful to God that he gave me this blessing so that I can share with the world, so that the world can know that Jesus Christ is Lord and Savior of our lives, and that he is our greatest hope and our only hope in these times.
Finally, my brother, who would you say is your biggest inspiration, musically or otherwise?
All right. First of all, my greatest inspiration is Jesus Christ.
Amen to that.
His humility, his love. And I tell persons my story, my story can be found in John chapter 9, because just to tell people a little bit about myself, I am visually impaired, legally blind. I was born that way. And a story in John chapter 9 in the Bible, you know, talks about a similar situation. And one of the texts that inspires me is that I must work the work of him that sent me while it is day. So God has given me this to be a blessing, and I plan to use it to his honor and glory. And musically, I have a whole list from the great Charlie Parker, Dizzy Gillespie, John Coltrane, and so many others, to today's artists. One of my dear friends, the guy who is actually hosting this program, Courtney Fadlin, is one of my big brothers and, you know, inspirations. And I am so honored to be here amongst great musicians and great music.
Awesome. Well, right now you're going to perform your second song for us called The Altar. Take it away, my brother.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Are you looking for a dependable service and the lowest cost for all your construction and road service needs? If so, contact us at 592-231-5876 or 592-675-6647. Those numbers again, 592-231-5876 or 592-675-6647. Welcome back. You're in tune to Sax Interpretations. If you're just joining us, my name is Deroy Soudan. I am the host for this evening. And our next artist is also a dear friend of mine. I call him the guy with the voice, man, and you'll see why. To say that Leighton Kennedy is a saxophonist would be a dishonest portrayal of what he's able to do when he's playing. It is very clear that he is passionate when he's playing, but around the notes is a specific intent. That intent is to give the listener a feeling of hope and healing. Leighton attended Atlantic Union College and the University of Massachusetts, Amherst, where he completed his undergraduate and graduate degrees in nursing. As a psychiatric nurse practitioner, Leighton often interacts and helps guide people who state that they have lost hope in their own way. As a musician with the saxophone, he has the tool and the ability to steer the hearts to brighter days ahead. He sees no difference in whatever he does because it's another opportunity to make others hopeful. This journey of playing the saxophone to help others has allowed Leighton to play on many different platforms, including playing in front of President Barack Obama, as well as being an opening act for gospel music artists such as Jackie Velasquez, J.J. Hairston, and featured on Duane Starling's live recording of Deeper Faith. He released his own recording in 2012 entitled My Heart, as well as a collection of Christmas projects, The Reason, with his dear friend, Reginald Reed. He is now, through this coronavirus COVID pandemic, Leighton has taken the opportunity to record and compose for a new project to be released later this year. Ladies and gentlemen, let's make welcome my friend and brother in Christ, Leighton Kennedy. Leighton, take it away. Thank you. That's my brother, my friend, and a great saxophonist also. Before I before I ask Leighton a couple of questions, let me just take a moment and acknowledge some of our listeners from both Facebook as well as YouTube. Leslyn Charles, thanks for watching. Yolande, thanks for watching. Nesta McFarlane, my brother from way back when. Thank you, my brother. Valder Aaron, thank you. Easton Blake, thank you. When I come back a little later, I'm going to acknowledge the rest of our guests. But Leighton, I have two questions for you, man. Yes, I've known you for a number of years. Yes, sir. And I've known this brother a long time before I even knew that he played the saxophone. Okay? Who inspired you to make music, Leighton?
Wow, that's a long history. I will just say that I was inspired.
Your mic is a little bit low.
Can you hear me?
No, I can hear you a little too low there.
So I was going to say that I was inspired a long time ago, you know, just hearing music in church and at home. You know, there's a lot of music around the home, you know, singing with family and being in choirs and, you know, that thing, you know, and also being in church all the time. You know, that's something that I just grew up with, and this was something that I enjoyed.
Awesome. Awesome. Now, as far as your music go, what is your normal process like when you're in the studio or when you're preparing to go into the studio?
Wow. Pretty much, I mean, I try to figure out what songs I'm going to be playing. I mean, I don't mm-hmm. know if it's, you're asking the question about the process of the creation of the album.
The creation of, yes, the creation.
Yeah, so I, a lot of times I try to think about, you know, what songs really hit me and what hit other people, what, you know, makes my heart move. But also there are times where there's songs I've played at, you know, wherever I've played and people have been really inspired by a certain song, that I tend to pick songs like that. And then the other thing is that there's sometimes there are tunes that are just running in my head. I tend to also do some own my personal compositions, which is something I'm going to do for my next song. And I, you know, work with someone. Sometimes I'm not able to complete the song, so I work with someone. Reggie Reed, in my first album, I worked with him. He's able to mm-hmm. kind of bring out, you know, the character to the songs.
Right.
To create it. So, yeah.
Awesome. Awesome. Before you play, though, we need to let our viewers know that your album is available on all digital platforms, including iTunes, CD Baby, Google Play. Yeah. Just Google Leighton Kennedy. And he also has a website, officialdutimemusic.wixsite.com/mysite. I know that's a little bit lengthy, but if you Google his name, I'm sure you'll be able to find him. Also, his other mental health business website is Innovate. Let's see, help me out with this.
InnovoLifeHealth.com.
That's InnovoLifeHealth.com. And if you want to book him, you can call 240-755-8675. I'll repeat, 240-755-8655. Or you can also email him at dewey.music@gmail.com. Now, Leighton, your second song, the original song, take it away, brother.
All right. Thanks a lot, man. Blessing. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
yes, beautiful music from my dear friend Leighton Kennedy. Thank you, Leighton, for those two beautiful renditions. We're going to take a quick break. When we return, music from Ian Hurd. Keep it locked right here. If you're just joining us, once again, you're in tune to Sax Interpretations. I'm your host, Delroy Soudan. Welcome back. Welcome back to Sax Interpretations. I'm your host, Delroy Soudan. This next artist, he is from the island of Jamaica, my home, and he's a graduate of Alpha Boys School. He has been a musician for over 35 years and a music educator for the past 30 years. Hurd is also composer, arranger, and the author of a book entitled I Hurd Music, which is a music workbook, levels 1 and 2. As a composer and arranger, he has written two musical cantatas, one entitled Rejoice and the other The Messiah Come and Rejoice the Messiah Live, and numerous original songs. He has taught at Jamaica School of Music, Arden High School, the University of Technology in Jamaica, and a lot of other institutions. Ian has graced the stage at numerous national events and has performed in Anguilla, Aruba, Belgium, Costa Rica, Curacao, the UK, Great Britain, Germany, to name a few. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome none other than the man himself, Mr. Ian Hurd. Thank you. Oh, yes. Beautiful music from the man himself, Mr. Ian Hurd. Ian Hurd, rather. Let me correct myself. Ian, how are you, my brother?
I'm good, thanks. Thanks for having me on the program.
Awesome, awesome. Sounding good, man. All right, so I have two questions for you.
Thank you.
If you could collaborate or open for any artist, who would that artist be?
Mr. Courtney Fadlin, one. Two. Gerald Albright.
Good choices. I like that. What is one message that you would like to send to your fan? Considering, you know, the times in which we're living, if you have to leave one message to your fans, what would that message be?
One message. Keep hope alive.
Amen. Simple message. Amen. And that's a good message right there. All right, so right now you're going to give us another track, right? And I believe it is Praise Is What We Do, a favorite of many people. Can you take it away, my brother? Would love to hear your rendition. Thank you. Praise is what I do. That's a beautiful song there. Praise is what I do. Listen, man, you know, given what is happening, not only in our country, but around the world, we need to be reminded to be in a worship mode always. Praise when things are good. Praise when things are bad. Just keep praising. Not only does it lift your spirit, but it makes you feel so much, so much, so much joy deep down inside. I can relate. I'm telling you something that I know for a fact. All right. When I return, I am going to be bringing you the music of Daniel Ryan. He's coming up momentarily. But before I do that, let me just take a moment to tell you guys about AMP Social. AMP Social is an alternative to Facebook. For all of you folks who have been complaining that Facebook is blocking you, Facebook is deleting your messages and stuff, be sure to check it out. AMPSocial.net. AMPSocial.net. Go there, sign up. You know, keep it positive, though. You know, we have to encourage positive things, especially in these day and age. We want to keep it positive. I'm going to take a quick break, and when I return, the music of Daniel Ryan. Keep it locked. Sax Interpretations, hosted by your boy, Delroy. Thanks, Courtney, for putting together this wonderful program. My hat goes off to you, my brother. All right, so we have Mr. Daniel Ryan right there on the screen with us. Daniel Ryan was born in the Twin Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. He began his musical journey at the age of 12 years old when his father encouraged him to pursue music. His innate ability started to emerge at the Five Rivers Government Secondary School, where his music teacher started him off with the clarinet. Shortly after that, he branched off to the tenor saxophone, in which he holds a grade 8 certificate from the Trinity College of Music, London, in practical. Daniel Ryan is a graduate of the University of the West Indies, where he holds a bachelor's degree in musical arts special program. Daniel's dedication to music has afforded him several opportunities to work with some of the Caribbean's finest musicians and, by extension, the international region. Daniel Ryan continues to push boundaries with his skills not only in the Caribbean, but also internationally. Apart from his responsibilities in Trinidad and Tobago, he is one of the many show bands musician with the Carnival Cruise Line, or the Carnival Cruise Line Company. I apologize for that. This is the only beginning, and he is driven to becoming greater. Daniel, take it away, my brother. Show us what you got. Thank you. Daniel, what was the name of that track, by the way?
That's When I Found Love.
When I Found Love. All right, Daniel, before we go into the interview, I have two questions for you, man. What would you be doing right now if it wasn't for your music career?
Okay, so I would probably be doing business or engineering, I would say.
That's good, that's good. So you also love engineering?
Yes, I specifically love business.
Nice, nice. Besides your musical instrument, do you sing any at all? Whether in
no,
the
I
show
don't sing.
Or otherwise?
I play other instruments, but I don't sing. I play the bass guitar, I play drums, I play piano, but
okay.
No vocals.
Nice, nice, nice. Well, you're doing great as it is, man. All right, we're going to hear your second number. What is the name of your upcoming piece?
It's called I Smile by Kirk Franklin.
Oh, nice, nice, nice. All right, so let's listen to that one. That's a favorite of a lot of people, if not everyone. So let's all listen as we smile. Take it away, bro.
Thanks, man.
Can you just smile? Carpet cleaning, pressure washing, upholstery service, and much more. Brandon's Janitorial was created with you in mind. We clean so you can stay safe and quarantine. Special discounts for hospitals and places affected by quarantine. Contact us at 592-225-7799. That's 592-225-7799.
Welcome back to Sax Interpretations. I am your host, Delroy Soudan. Listen, man, I don't know about you guys out there, but I am enjoying the music, period. Each and every artist so far, I am blessed by, I'm encouraged by. And you know what? You can also sow into these individual ministries, man. You can inbox Courtney's, and he will give you the information for each of the artists that you've heard so far. Daniel Ryan, Ian Hurd, Roy Stewart, and Leighton Kennedy. And coming up next, we have none other than Damian Elliott. Damian is standing by, but let me just give you a little bit of background on Damian. Over the years, Damian has cultivated and strived to master a style of his own, which resonates with everyone he encounters. He hails from Jamaica, where his musical journey gave birth and blossomed into what it is today. He is known for his elegant signature style and credits his delivery to God, who taught his hands to war and fingers to fight. I like that. Damian goes by the stage name of Elegant Music, which derives from the terms Elegant and Elliot, merging together to create the brand. With his enthusiasm and humanitarian skills, he has managed to build strong relationships through the music ministry God has entrusted him. Consisting of myriads of listeners, Damian credits Kirk Whalum and Courtney Fadlin as two of his major influences. He studied piano but have always loved the saxophone, and these influences lead him to pursuing his bachelor's degree in music education and performance at the Edna Manley College of Visual and Performing Arts in Jamaica. He continues to build a reputation as well as capable saxophonist who has gained local and international recognition as he delivers each ministry and performance with grace, humility, style, and precision. Let's make welcome Damian Elliott. Thank you. in the end. Well done, my brother. You know what? Before I ask you your two questions, I just need to acknowledge some of the people in the chat room. And let me tell you, the list has grown a lot. We have Jethro Fadlin, that's Courtney's dad, I believe. Marva Patterson, Claudia. We have Julie Forbes, Delise, Teacher Thomas, Teacher Sanja or Sanya. We have Craig Griffiths, Kerry, how you doing, girl? Long time no see. Joy Simmons Brown, Russell Songbird, Bonita, whole lot of people in the chat. You know what? The list is so long. This list is very long. But I want you to know that we see you. We acknowledge you. Thank you so much for checking out this concert this evening. And by the way, in addition to the concert being available on Facebook and YouTube, it will also be made available on NSound TV. That's at nsoundtv.com. You can also download the NSound TV app available for Android. You can also, you know, go there and check that out as well. Additionally, we do have a Roku channel that you can also add us to your Roku and enjoy good gospel music from Africa, the Caribbean, and everywhere in between. So it has been great. Great, great, great. Damien, I have two questions for you, my brother.
Sure.
Okay. Where have you performed and what are your favorite and least favorite venue to perform in? Thinking about it? I think we're having a little bit of sound issue right there. Can you hear him?
Can you hear me?
Say that again. Okay, I'm not hearing you. You need to talk in the microphone.
All right, let me use this.
That's better. Yes.
Can you ask those two questions again?
Okay, so my question again would be, where have you performed, one, and what is your least favorite venue to perform in?
Oh, so I've performed here in Mass, Connecticut, Jamaica. Those three places. I haven't gone anywhere.
Well,
I haven't gone global as yet.
The time is coming, bro. It's coming.
All right, thank you.
And what would you say is your least favorite place to perform in?
So that's pretty much easy because I am a minister, by the way. I am a minister of music. So everything that speaks to secular, that's out of the window. So
okay.
I'm primarily in church.
Awesome, awesome.
That's my description. So
that's good. Easy. Awesome, man. So can you tell us what's the next song you're about to play? And just introduce it for me briefly.
Okay, so let me just make mention of the first song. So the first song was Thy Kingdom Come, and that was composed by Kirk Whalum. There's something significant about this season. When we pray Thy Kingdom Come and Thy Will Be Done, it's a very serious prayer model. Mm. And one thing I have observed is that if we're not prepared for God's kingdom to come, then we should not pray that your kingdom come, because God's kingdom, when we go back to the story of Nebuchadnezzar, we recognize that Nebuchadnezzar, he built a kingdom that was made by hands, of course. It had nothing to do with God. And we saw a kingdom coming that was not made by hands, crushing the kingdom of Nebuchadnezzar. So when we say thy kingdom come, even in this dispensation that we're living in, I believe that God has a hand in what's going on, because at the end of the day, his kingdom must stand, and to his kingdom there is no end. So that was the reason why I chose to play this song. And the other song I'll be doing is Brooke, and this song was written by one of my very good friend Pastor Cawley. And I just decided that I would just do the instrumental version to it. Brooke, it's about Elijah and the brook. When the brook dries up, what is it that you're going to do? wait on a word from God, and trust in his words. Amen.
Awesome. Can't wait to hear it. Damien, that was beautiful. Two beautiful numbers from Damien Elliott. And let me tell you, man, I don't know about you, but I am blessed. You know, we have a lot going on right now, a lot in this country and a lot around the world. And sometimes we have to take a break from all of the chaos, take a break from the news cycle, because they're feeding us nothing but negative images. And people are just going wild and crazy nowadays, you know, racism, so many issues that we're facing right now. And so being here this evening and being able to host this show is a ray of hope. It tells me that there is life after everything that's happening. There is life. There is hope. There is peace. There is calm and all of that good stuff. So let's all remain hopeful and not hopeless through it all. Want to acknowledge Mercedes Ware. Want to acknowledge Claudia Bravo, Ezra Isaac. Want to acknowledge Fender Sachs. Not sure if that's someone's name or the name of a company. Want to acknowledge Gershom Bias Jr., Kamal Bloomfield, Kina, Arkina, Henry, Bonita, so many people right here, right now, just enjoying this music. And if you are encouraged and is blessed by the ministry of each one of the artists you've heard so far, inbox Courtney's, inbox Courtney, and we will give you their information. Please sow a seed in each person's ministry. It takes money for them to make these albums. It takes money to go into the studio. So by you listening and enjoying their ministry, please consider sowing a seed into each person, okay? We asking that kindly. Also, Courtney Fadlin's Cash App information is on the screen. You can purchase each person's music as well. And, you know, let's sow into the body of Christ, man. That's what it's all about. All right, we're going to take a quick break, and when I return, Sheldon Palmer is on the way. Keep it locked.
Are you looking for a dependable service and the lowest cost for all your construction and road service needs? If so, contact us at 592-231-5876 or 592-675-6647. Those numbers again, 592-231-5876 or 592-675-6647.
Welcome back. Once again, if you're joining us, you're in tune to Sax Interpretations. I am your host, Delroy Seldon. Want to thank Courtney Fadlin once again for putting this awesome event together, man. It's truly a blessing to see so many saxophonists coming together, interpreting the music their way. No two sound alike. And that's the beauty about music. You know, it's a beautiful thing when like-minded people come together for the common cause. There is no jealousy, no competition. You know, it's a beautiful thing, man. It really is. Well, our next performer is none other than Sheldon Palmer. Born to a family already ingrained in music during his primary years in his birthplace of Manchester, Jamaica. That's where I went to school. He was introduced to what would become a music-filled life via his participation in church and community activities, praise and worship sessions, functions at school, and for family members and friends would become his arena and stomping ground to unleash his musical talent for various instruments. There was, however, one in particular that he loved dearly, the saxophone. To further couch his talent, Palmer attended Edna Manley College of Visual Arts from 2004 until 2008. Having reattended his aforementioned college, he also attained an associate degree in popular music studies, as well as a bachelor's of arts in music education by 2014 under great tutelage of Major Joe Williams and, guess who, Courtney Fadlin. This experience further propelled his professional journey, which allowed him to seek guidance as well as have the opportunity to play with some of the greats in reggae music. And he has played with a whole lot of people. I'm just going to give you a fraction of who he's played with. Morgan Heritage, one of my favorite new artists, Chronix, Zinc Fence Redemption Band, Toots and the Maytals, Alain, Assassin, aka Agent Sasko, Julian Marley, to name a few. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome none other than the man himself, Sheldon Palmer. Beautiful song. That one, I believe, was entitled Free from Sheldon Palmer. Let me just take a quick moment to acknowledge the Adventist Musician Network for streaming this program. They are, supporting us. They're one of the supporters of this awesome concert. And once again, this concert is not only going to be available on YouTube and Facebook, but also the Adventist Musician Network and also NSound TV. Sheldon,
yes, how you doing, man? I'm good.
Great work, man. Great job. Listen, I have a question for you. Two questions, as a matter of fact. The first one, who are you hoping to reach with your music? What's the inspiration behind the music, and who are you hoping to reach?
As long as you can hear, it's for you.
Ah, good answer, my brother. Good answer. All right. Now, my second question, in light of what is taking place, not only here in America, but around the world, it's all over television. We see what's happening. Do you have any word of encouragement or advice, not only for the body of Christ, but for everyone?
It's kind of, first of all, let me just start by saying, like, I feel I'm thankful for you guys having me on the program, even though you guys put me after all these great people. You know,
you were great to me.
I tried to keep up. Yeah, but it's very sad to see everything that's going on. I'm on social media every day, and I'm seeing so much evil that is taking place in our world, and it's hard right now to have a level head. And I know this program is to distract us from everything that is going on out there, but representing my black race, now is not the time to ease up. I'm not taking my foot off the gas. I am for one race, the human race, and I'm with the fight until the rest of the world, because the rest of the world accept us as equals. Mm. I work with a lot of white people across the world. I work with a lot of people of different race. And the fact of it is, even some of my friends who are in the majority don't really understand what we're going through or we've been going through. I mean, honestly, we just got to keep our heads up, man. I don't have the right words to encourage people. But right now, all I got to say, y'all, don't keep your foot off the gas. We have to push and end this senseless evil that's in our world. And at the same time, we have to pray and give God thanks for where we are, where we're coming from, and where we need to go.
Well said, my brother. Well said. Now you have one more song for us, Ancient Worlds. Is that the title of the song coming up?
Ancient Words.
Ancient Words. Oh, I read it wrong. All right, bro, take it away and continue to bless us with your ministry.
Yeah, man, bless up. Recognize all the things that's happening in the world right now, and it's very sad to know that we as black race have to separate ourselves from the human race, or we seem to be separated from the human race. But we all got to recognize that we're one race. This song goes out to the family of George Floyd.
Mm-hmm.
Welcome back to Sax Interpretations. I am your host, Deroy Soudan. Over many years, Guyanese, Jamaican saxophonist Courtney Fadlin. You see, Courtney was born in Guyana, raised in Jamaica, citizen of America, hence Guyanese, Jamaican, if you didn't get it. I've known Courtney for exactly 37 years. Courtney, that's how old we are. And be proud of it. 37 years, man. Because the reality of it is that if I turn that backwards, it will be 73 years. So just accept 37, my brother, all right? Courtney Fadlin has developed and mastered a style all of his own. He has influenced many of today's up-and-coming artists along the way with his signature style and silky smooth delivery, affectionately known as the Sax Man. Courtney is redefining and his undeniable sound and texture. You know what? I don't even want to continue reading this bio because I know this brother. Courtney is one of the kindest individuals I know. I'm not talking as a musician right now. Forget about that. We know the brother is bad when it comes to his craft. But Courtney has seen me at my worst. He's seen me at my best. He has offered advice. He's counseled. Sometimes I believe that there were times when he wanted to beat the crap out of me too. Courtney is a true friend by every definition of the word. Courtney has accomplished great things throughout his career. He has traveled to Africa, Europe, the Caribbean, and his children and his family means more to him than anything else in this world, even more than his music. I know this because I know the brother. Courtney has a heart of gold comparable to very few, and I have some very dear friends, all of which equally have hearts of gold. I first met Courtney in 1982 when I first lay foot on the campus of West Indies College as a high school student. And I told Courtney this story before. When I first met this brother, I couldn't stand a bone in his body. Why, I didn't know, but Courtney and I have become inseparable as friends. I look up to him, not just as a friend, but as a brother, because people may talk about him, they may talk about me, but he's always defended me. I've always defended him. We all have flaws, but at the end of the day, I can go to him and say, this is what's happening, and rest assured that I'm going to walk away being better than I went before. Courtney credits a lot of people, including Grover Washington, David Sanborn, and a lot of other people along the way. And the people who have influenced Courtney has led him to one of the greatest musical institutions in this country, Berklee College of Music in Boston, Massachusetts, where he completed a Bachelor's of Music in Professional Music. He also went to the University of Massachusetts in Lowell, where he pursued a master's in music studies. Additionally, he has mastered his clarinet and flute. And recently, he has received a master's, his second master's degree in saxophone performance from the California Baptist University in Riverside, California. Courtney continues to make his mark, not only in the church circles, but around the globe. Today's artists have credited him many a times. But the most important quality that Courtney has, and I mean this with all my heart, Courtney has not changed since high school. Still approachable, still silly sometimes, still talk trash sometimes. But these are the qualities that make him who he is. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you my friend, my brother, my mentor, Courtney Fadlin. Take it away, my brother. I love you, man.
Thank you.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. Me not spend me money for nothing. Courtney, oh, that is awesome, yes, man. Listen. I am eternally proud of you, man. We've come a long way. We certainly have come a long way. Of all the interviews that I've done over many, many years, I've never actually interviewed you, but that's coming. Who would you say is your greatest influence? I already know, but I'm asking you anyway.
Well, you know, my dad.
Of course.
my dad, right? I'm not saying that because he's watching right now, but I remember as a kid, I would see my dad teaching music, never really understanding what exactly what entails to be a musician. But whenever someone would ask me, what is it that you like to do when you grow up? I said, a musician. But didn't know I had to put in all this work and everything. It looks easy, right?
Yeah.
But my dad.
Awesome. You know, and you mentioned your dad. I remember being on the campus of Westernis College and watching your dad play. He didn't just play that piano, man. He made that piano talk, sing, dance. I remember it as if it was yesterday, you know. So, Mr. Fadlin, Senior,
I'm not sure he can remember.
I remember. Trust me, I remember it like yesterday, you know. So, also want to acknowledge our engineer behind the scenes, man.
Indeed,
Mr. Mark Henry. Yes. I remember little Mark on campus, and Courtney reminded me the other day when I used
to pull up his pants to his navel.
when I used to operate the music system at the college auditorium, Mark was always there, taking in and soaking in everything. Sometimes we thought he was just nosy. And today, Mark is engineering this entire production. All I have to do is sit here and talk, you know. So, Mark, I have to give you your props. Also, Courtney.
Yes, sir.
I know you're a family man. I know your wife supports you 100%. For those of us, or for those people who do not know, what does family mean to you?
Yeah, sorry about that. Yeah, man, family means everything to me. It's important to have a supportive family.
Mm-hmm.
I was just saying to someone, I remember when CJ was a little kid, a little boy, and whenever you go anywhere and you're performing, and should someone start talking behind him, he would tell them to shh, you know? And up to this day, as a grown young man, he would still want to carry my saxophone around and let everyone know that that's my dad. And it's always good to be around my kids, especially these little ones here. They would ask me on a daily basis, Daddy, when are you going to practice? Caleb would ask, when are you going to practice? Are you having a concert? When are you going to be practicing? So going away on trips, coming back home is always a joy. You're always counting down the hours, the days of coming back home, and just to see the smiling faces and the hugs and kisses. And, you know, so it means a lot to me, man.
I can't imagine. I can't imagine. You know, it's a joy to see you every time. I never get tired of hearing you. And I'm not just saying this as a friend. Everybody was on point today, man. Exactly. Roy Stewart, Ian Hurd, Daniel Ryan, Damian Elliott, yes. Sheldon Palmer, Leighton yes. Kennedy.
My
you
Lord.
Guys did an awesome job. Yes, but yes. you know, before your final performances, I must say that we as a people, we cannot and we must not be silent now. We must continue to stand in the face of evil. We must continue to be on the right side of good. There is no time to be scared or be fearful. We must, however, put on the armor of God and go fighting with all our might. Do not allow anyone, under no circumstance, to tell you that you are less than. What is happening in this country right now? It's been a long time coming. Unfortunately, properties have got to be damaged. Properties can be restored. Your lives cannot. Once it's taken, it's taken.
That's it. Yes.
We have to continue the fight. Let this concert serve as a reminder that you should not be glued to the television listening to all of this negative stuff every day, not taking a break. I'm guilty of that because we all want to stay informed and we all want to know what's going on in our world. But there's a time where you have to just step back from all the noise and allow the voice of God to be heard. And this performance, these performances to me today was the voice of God. Let it sink into your heart. Go back, revisit the performances, whether on YouTube, whether on Facebook, whether on Sound TV, wherever. But do not get distracted. Continue to stay steadfast. Courtney, once again, I want to say thank you for putting together an awesome event. And by the way, ladies and gentlemen, Sax Interpretations Female Edition will be coming soon. All female saxophonists. So make sure that you keep that in your minds, that it's coming very soon. And we will let you know exactly when. Thanks, Courtney. Yeah. Have yourself a great evening, everyone.
Thanks, Delroy, for coming on board, and Mark, and all my friends that have lent their support and coming and performing. And I think it was an awesome concert. Thanks to everyone for tuning in. All the folks in Trinidad, you came on to see Ryan. In a couple of weeks, we're going to have your girl. You know who I'm talking about in Trinidad. Rennell, you guys know Rennell? Harry Narine? Yes, yes. Arnesia Williams Hurd, that's the wife of Ian Hurd. And who else? We have Barbara Witter from Jamaica. And we have quite a few persons coming up, so tune in. So thank you guys. Thanks everyone for watching and spending this time with us. Go out and be careful. And I just want to say, with everything that is happening around us, and sometimes when we talk about race, some of my friends who were not of my race would say things like, everyone is important. And some of our folks back in the Caribbean would say we complain too much. But I've been living in this country long enough to know what I've been through personally. I was arrested and charged. I had to go to court for playing my saxophone because I had a neighbor who thinks that I shouldn't be practicing. Even the law says that I was in the right to practice. And the cops would come every day and they said, listen, Mr. Fatlin, we're here because homeboy downstairs called 911 and you're in your private condo and you have a right. And you know, they would listen outside when I'm practicing. They said, but there's nothing to disturb the neighbor. But one day, some guys showed up, man, and banged me on my my fridge, or was my my microwave, took me, I would never forget, 2001, the 14th of February, 2001, Massachusetts, cold, still winter, six backup cars, put me in a paddy wagon, and my cousin Irvin Henry had to bring shoes for me because when I said, can I put on my shoe, the guy said, no, you're going to jail. All because I said, listen, man, the Attorney General's office says that I have a right to practice in my space after 9 a.m., and not before 9 a.m. and not after 10 at night. It was 1 o'clock. I have been harassed several times driving in Massachusetts. Oh, you're not wearing your seatbelt. I say, I'm wearing my seatbelt. So sometimes people say things, you know, I've experienced it in school. And I must confess, I went to a school in California, California Baptist University. I've never had any problems with any of my teachers. All of my teachers were Caucasian, right? I have some great teachers that I call friends right now. My saxophone professor, Professor Dan Sitmorase, he would pray for me. I remember getting back to the States to go to school, and my wife was the one who encouraged me to go back to school and said, this is what you wanted to do, and I give her all the praise for that. And Professor Dan would pray with me. Several occasions, and I know sometimes I can see his heart. So we can't just generalize and say, you can't look and say, all black people are bad, we're all thieves, all white people are bad, or all Caucasian are bad, or all Asians are racist. Not everyone. It comes with individuals. And it's all, right now I'm saying, all we have to do is show love, right? I stand as a proud black man, or my wife don't let me to use that term, I'm a descendant of what? African is right? Yes, I'm an Afro-Caribbean. Mixed up with, I call myself a Guide American. My God. But I'm thankful that I'm alive and I've, you know, listening to all these guys talk and just to be an inspiration to them. I've seen Sheldon grow as an awesome sax player. I've been friends with Sheldon. They call Sheldon my big son. Roy Stewart, doing great on the sax. My buddy, Damien Elliott, are we talk on a daily basis, talking music and life, relationships, marriage and everything. And Leighton Kennedy, who has been an awesome brother to me. Mm-hmm. He's been there for me, and so I give him you. Ryan is, I'm yet to meet Ryan. Ryan was introduced to me by Renell, Harry and Ryan from Trinidad. And he seemed like a great guy, and I said, I'd love to have him on the show. And I add him on Facebook and WhatsApp. We've been communicating. So I thank you guys for coming on board. I had an awesome time. I had to just look from the beginning to the end and just said, you know, I just want to enjoy this. So thank you guys. Thank you, Ian. Thank everybody. Enjoy the rest of the weekend. Be safe. Bless you. Remember, Delroy has said it, you know, just support us or ministry or whatever. You have weddings. We don't mind doing some stuff free sometimes. We are available, some of us are teachers. We're available for private music lessons, saxophone, clarinet, flute, in the various countries here in the States, Guyana, Trinidad. Just hit us up an email. Just send a nice word. A lot of you have been saying that, so I appreciate you. I love you guys. Until next time. Thank you, Delroy. Thank you, Mr. Henry.
Time, bro.
And thank you, guys. Mark has been spending hours,
like, I know, man,
working on this week after week. And in 2 weeks, I don't know if Delroy mentioned that we've been having a few friends. So look out for the, I have some surprises. So look out for it. All right, guys. God bless.
Come back, guys. Things are gonna get thank you.